Do you hear? You hear? He doesn't care anymore. But I care about doing the time. Do you want me on my knees? Maybe you want money? I'll give it. Everyone wants money. Do you know my family? Each problem of yours will be solved.
No. No. Could you please show me the ring? Sure. Here you are. No, it's not that, Tolik. Do you understand? Absolutely not.
What's the matter? It looks okay.
Let me try another one. Do you sell the thing like that? Unfortunately not. Where did you get it? My granny gave this medallion to my dad. It's a family heirloom. You see, Tolik, it's a real thing with historical meaning, and it's just nothing. Let's do without history.
How come?
History, you know, is more precious than gold. It makes any trinket seem special. And this is all. Excuse us. We'll see you some other time. Let's go.
I'm sorry. What's the matter?
I don't care about it. I've got plenty of rings.
Closed.
Tolik, history is more precious than gold, isn't it? Come on, can you get everything there? I have Pasha on second shift, and I have to pick up the kids from kindergarten. Sure, no worries. Thanks, darling. See you. It's beautiful.
Young lady, can I have a word with you?
Roma?
I'll give you a ride. Come on, Martha, don't slow down.
Whose car is it?
Ours. Do you like it?
I do. But you were not going to buy. We still have to pay the rent.
No, I wasn't going to, but yesterday I happened to find a good option, and we'll pay the rent. Martha, what's wrong? She is not new, rather cheap. I'm having a hard time without a car. It'll all be all right, you'll see. We'll get through this. You believe me?
I do.
Let's go then. What are we waiting for? Hello?
Ihor Valentinovich, Metro is here to see you.
Hi, Dad. He's already here. Thanks. You called. What are you doing? I'm running late for the race. Your secretary said you wanted to see me. I'll leave my suit here until tomorrow. Is that okay? The secretary, as you called her, has a name. I was just watching a video of your adventures. Just warming up for the race. This warm-up will cost you. I no longer intend to pay fines for you. Yes. So Yuri Oleksiyevich snitched. And you, Uncle Mikhailo, handed me over to my own father. As a faithful and loyal, well, how can I put it? Stop it. What does Yuri Oleksiyevich need this time? A new dwelling, or maybe a rank. You be smart for me here. He's running late for the race. Hey, aren't you forgetting one thing? You're a lawyer in this company. Have you read the contract? Have you checked the landowners? Yeah, I forgot. How about tomorrow? I'm going on a work trip tomorrow. You had a week for this job. You missed a very important contract. Hey, why are you shouting? Who cares about this cottage town in Vasilyevsk? I have never even heard the name. Uncle Mikhailo, you say it. Who is Uncle Mikhailo to you? No more racing, neither in the city nor on the track. You understand me? How's that for racing? It is. You made a mess of things last night. You had the whole highway police on alert. And in the daytime, Nastya, that secretary whose name you can't remember for 3 years, saw you sleeping at your desk. You're going to ruin my business. Your business? I can't remember Oleksiy giving you his share. If you keep racing around the city, I'll tell Yuri Oleksiyevich to take you into custody. He has gotta catch up with me first. What are you laughing at?
Hi.
Hello.
How are you? What's that?
I fell off my skateboard. It's okay. It happens.
Again?
Hi.
Hi, Mom.
Come on. Aunt Rhea? How are you?
Well, you know. How is school?
It's okay. Working hard for my medal.
Here, where you're living. Just hide it. Not like before.
And you?
I have some. No worries. Not drinking. Not drinking. You see that? She decided to teach her mother to live. And mother needs no help, right? Right. She just raised her, took her out.
Mom, don't you start.
Do not start what? This should be enough food for a week. If you need anything, you just call me and I'll get it for you. By Kostya. By Mum.
Goodbye. Bye. Every time I wonder about how you and Kostya grew up so nice.
She was not like that before.
As long as I remember her, she has always been like that. Okay, baby, forget it. You can't do anything about her. Yurka came out of his forest. What about celebrating the car?
You go. I need to get up early tomorrow. And honestly, I don't feel like it.
As you wish.
That's it. It's worth 2 months waiting from Paris. No need to try anything else. Right, Senya? Yes, this is it. Hold on. Where am I going to hide it for so long? What if Andriy sees it? So what? So what? You know, it's bad luck. Unhappy marriage, stuff like that. Unhappy marriage. Is it about Volkov? Just relax, please. You have a great fiancé. Young, ambitious, successful. Your father has already welcomed him into the family. You'll have the best wedding of the year. You'll make the most beautiful bride. Understand? That's all you have to think about right now. Now, hurry up and get ready, or we'll be late. Sure. Who cares about my wedding when my brother's out racing? I need to arrange my private life too. I agree. Sonia, I've decided to keep the dress at the salon until the wedding. Sure, no problem.
The race favorites are pilots Dmitry Parfyonov and Oli Smeshko, best friends and everlasting competitors. Both pilots were incredibly cool in yesterday's qualifying, and both made it into the top three of our Capital Cup competition. Dmitry, who took the third place in the qualification, was less than a second ahead of Ola, and just by a few points. Today, the track will judge them. Dmitry Parfyonov is a son of a well-known businessman and one of the main candidates for the mayor of our city, Ihor Valentinovich Parfyonov. Therefore, he is the focus of special attention of the press and viewers today. Oli Smeshko has already completed the stage, scoring 95 points out of 100 possible. He again demonstrated his perfect style. He goes through the track in a controlled drift, literally burning up the tires of his car. Such a speed, such a result. Branded aggressive style, great skill, and complete dedication. Look from the drift to the turn. Come on, give it a little more gas.
What happened?
Dimin. Dimin. Dimin, we don't know what condition Dmitry Parfyonov is in now, but most importantly, he is alive. We will be following the events carefully. Now we have to break our broadcast. We will update you on the rider's condition in our next program. It's delicious. No one makes cheesecakes like you.
Really? I'm happy. It's time to confess that Alexei is, was, and will be your favorite. Yeah. What are you doing here so early this morning? I wanted us to enjoy breakfast together. Vika, take a seat and eat properly. I can't. I'm going to catch the school bus. Mom, why can't we skip school today? I'll do something really worthwhile. What could be more useful than your studies? Sure. She has getting more and is more difficult. She's being rude. Moody.
15 years old, puberty. That is normal.
You weren't like that.
I might have been. Remember Dima?
Yes. Dima never let us feel bored. Actually, just like now. I asked him to join us for breakfast. And where is he? Thank you for coming, for making time.
Is that a reproach, Mom? Your husband's at work all the time, too. And he's not with us right now, unless he's hiding in the bushes from me.
Why are you being like this after all these years? Can't you get used to a whore?
Come on, don't start.
Yes, he's not an easy person, but he's my husband. We're a family. Not to mention that you run the same company.
That was your decision. Listen, you are free to dispose of your shares any way you want. I have no complaints. You decided to bring him into the company. That's fine. I'm just trying to mind my own business and avoid him as much as possible. And you have to understand, I'm here at his house. I don't feel comfortable.
How's Anya, Dania? It seems to me they can visit us more often. Christine could have them over on a regular basis. What keeps her from visiting?
You are in a good mood today. You're right. Nothing keeps her from visiting more often. I'll talk to her. Okay. Thank you. Let's just say we enjoyed our breakfast in a relaxed environment.
Yeah.
I have to go. Say hi to Dmitro. Okay. I gotta go. Yeah, hello? What? Martha, your bag.
How nice. Sorry, I'm late. Good morning. Not a good one for you. You refined for being late. Okay. Why did she come so early? Why are you late? I don't know. Roma got home late. I couldn't sleep. Work, huh? Oh, come on. All right. Just answer one question. How long have you guys been together? 7 years? And he still won't propose. If not for Ramka, then you'd have left a long time ago. Remember what your dreams were. You said you didn't plan to stay in Vasilyevsk forever, that there were many possibilities in the capital. You wanted to enter a college. You were going to design jewelry. And what are you doing? And you? What? I always knew where I belong. My life is different. I have different goals. Family is most important for me. I am where they are, and I never had other wishes. And you? You are different. Take a rack. Good morning. Hello.
Good morning. Show them into my office and ask to wait. I have a hiccup.
I slept peacefully and didn't feel anything. He's here alone. Mom, why alone? Andrei and I stayed at the hospital all night. You should have called us immediately. We decided to let you know after the operation.
Vera Fedorovna, it was my decision.
Mom, this is a doctor.
Your son has a serious chest trauma and a severe heart contusion. He was lucky to be wearing a helmet and a protective suit. Doctor, let's be more specific. Your prognosis? The prognosis is good. The surgery went well. He's stable. His life is out of danger. He was born with a silver spoon in his mouth. You'll be able to take him home in a few days.
Doctor, thank you so much. I'm happy he'll be home soon. Vera Fedorovna. My dear, how is he? How terrible. And I spent the night at my friend's, and that is it. Alexei called. Hi.
Hi.
How's he?
The doctor said he'll be awake soon. I'll check on him.
Dad's on his own.
So you enjoyed writing? Dad, the doctors say you were lucky this time. Who do you get that from? Okay, here we go. Your mother nearly had a heart attack. You should have thought about her. One more thing. You're fired. Your access to the trust fund will be cut off. Ivy been taking it long enough. Vera, he's awake. You can see him. I'm off. I'll show you out. I got news. Ihor Valentinovich. The bank's credit council has approved a preliminary loan for the construction of the cottage town. Part of the loan will be transferred immediately to offshore, and the estimate, you know, should be increased by about 30%. No problem, we'll get it done. But there is one thing. The credit agreement should be signed by Strelnitsky. Why? You own a company together with him, which means you're both responsible for the loan obligations. I'll get it done. And what about the land? You see, I'm here. Mikhailo went to Vasilyevsk.
Thank you.
I'm from Parfyonov. I guessed it. Why didn't Fyodor Ilyich come? He died 6 months ago. A tragic accident at a construction site. It is a pity. He was a good man. He didn't want this land and whatever's under it for money. Stop pretending to be cheap. Bring the papers. I don't have them yet. Yeah, I promised. But I was hoping that my classmate who worked in land administration could help. Yeah, but she was vindictive. She decided to take revenge for bothering her at school. She said that there would be no construction on our preserve. Can you imagine? That's your problem. Yeah. You got the money. I did. Figure it out. I got it. I'll take care of it. I need a different approach. You'll find it. I bet you will. Of course. Can I take that? Sure. Why are you staring? Looks like we both got in trouble. Oh, shit.
Dimak, how are you?
And who are you?
Dima, I'm your sister. This is our mom. Dima.
You are so easy to fool.
Not funny.
Oh, don't be mad. Mom, how are you?
I'm fine. Thanks to Ola, who saved you from the burning car.
I'm sorry, but you have to leave the ward. The patient requires rest.
Yes, doctor, I'm sorry. You go. Can I stay? I won't get any peace at home anyway.
Okay.
Come on.
Good morning. Have a seat.
Ior Valentinovic, we heard about your son's accident.
Yes, thank you. It'll be fine. Do I need to make any statements?
No, if no one was hurt, it's better not to.
Good. Then let's go to work. I am running for mayor because I care about the city. It hurts to see our beloved capital decaying. It is the main message of my campaign. Is that clear? Sure, everything is clear. We are working on a positive image. Clear.
But Lukin Preliminary is leading in all the polls.
People like him because he is young and energetic. In addition, they consider him to be one of them. So, you should play on the contrast. What makes you different from Lukin?
Look, you have a friendly big family. We can promote it as family values above all.
A friendly family? Not bad. Let's work on that. Is your friend feeling better?
Yes, she's fine now. I really miss spending time with my friends. So Lizka and I chatted and went to sleep. Did the children behave?
They were fine. I let the babysitter go and took care of them by myself. Dania made such a thing.
The subscriber cannot receive your call. Please try again later.
The papers for the construction loan are ready. The only thing missing is Strelnitsky's signature. There should be no problems with other stuff. We can meet with the head of the credit committee next week. I can't make it during the week. I'm going to Vasilyevsk. Is it possible to change it? No, it isn't. Okay, I'll deal with it. What? Mykajlo, you disagree? Yes, I do. It'll take us a long time to get the papers this way. If you had followed my recommendation, everything would have been fixed. Your recommendation? No, Mikhailo. Things should be done carefully. So hold off on these wild methods of yours. If you corner this bird lover, he will start talking out of fear. If they find out what the land is really for, stay out of this. I'll deal with it. Can't you wait till tomorrow? I like your passion. Don't waste it. How's it going with the customers? It's fine. I trust Andrei like I trust myself. They offered a double price. It's not the limit, so don't give up so fast. They also seek guarantees, and they keep an eye on the land situations through their channels. We need to deal with the papers as soon as possible. It is a technical matter. Yuri Early. Good morning, Alexei. Morning. What can I do for you? I need your signature on a bank agreement. I fixed the land allocation issue, and the construction loan is also almost settled. It's a good deal, Alexei. The company needs it. As I take it, we're talking about constructing on the territory of the Vasilyevsk Nature Reserve, and this is forbidden by law. Formalities. You understand? No, I don't understand, and I will not sign any of it. This company was created not by you, but by my father. and he cared a lot about such formalities. Listen, we have a hard relationship. It's just the way it is. It's my fault. I understand that. But still, you are aware of the construction crisis. And such a big project will keep the company alive. Your father's life work. Who was my friend, by the way? Are you practicing your election speech? You are wasting time. Hello?
Alexei Viktorovich, reporter, is coming to see you this afternoon.
Thank you, Katya. Bring me a cup of coffee, please.
Sure.
Thank you.
Breakfast is ready.
Thanks.
Then we can talk about when you got home last night.
Okay.
Can you give me a ride to work?
I can't. The car's gone.
What happened?
I got caught up. I invested in a risky thing. And I got screwed.
Okay. It happens.
That is not all. I borrowed from some very serious people. I thought I could get out of it, but yesterday it was clear that things were going to end. They gave me a week to give the money back. They took the car as payment for the debt. Here's how it is.
There should be a way out. I have some money. Not much, but still. We'll find more. We can ask for a reprieve.
A reprieve, Martha? These are the wrong people.
We'll think of something. We'll borrow it. I don't know.
There is a way out of this. You're not gonna like it. But I've thought it through.
What's that?
You can take the money from your store for a few days until we find the proper sum.
What do you mean? I'll talk to Katerina, of course, but you know our relationship.
Why is Katerina involved? Does she count the money each day? You have the safe keys. I just need 10K.
Are you being serious?
I told you wouldn't like it. Just a few days, I'll fix it and pay you back.
I can't do that. Roma. She trusts me.
Trusts? You're always complaining about her pressuring you. She won't even know.
Roma, no. Roma, I love you very much, but I can't do this. Please understand. We'll think of something else.
Sure, we will. That is all your love. Oh, shit.
Dima, why don't you put aside the phone down and finish your broth?
Thanks, Mom. I'm not hungry. Look at that.
No, I can't look at that.
Just pieces. It is a pity. Most importantly, it is not clear where to find the money for a new one.
A new one? You could have died.
Mom, Racing is my life. I'm sorry, you know that. Okay, we won't talk about that right now because my father fired me and cut off my access to the trust fund. You know, I was thinking about going away for a while. I'll recover and figure out what to do with my life anyway.
What about Zhenya's wedding?
Mom, she'll understand. Zhenya will understand.
And there's a similar one, but look at this. And this? I can offer you these. They make a great combination. No. Alexei, thank you for meeting with us. So, tell us about your project in detail.
Ecological building is a new field which we are now engaged in. The concept of building an ecological dwelling obliges to consider its basic principles. Eco-building contributes to the conservation of natural energy resources, distances people from nature destruction, combines harmoniously the achievements of scientific and technological progress and urbanization with the advantage of the natural environment. We are committed to making our homes comfortable for urban residents, at that not violating the balance in nature. I should say that eco-construction is becoming increasingly large-scale and complicated in nature. Modern trends include the construction of entire eco-cities where nature. As I said, eco-construction contributes to the conservation of natural and energy resources. Our company applies innovative methods in construction. The latest developments and materials. I believe that our houses will become real safe islands for the environment. Scientific research keeps offering new solutions. The concept of the familiar passive, it means
I'm home. Roma, let's talk.
End of the first episode.